Once you've integrated Stripe and MailerLite in your landing page or website builder, you'll be able to use the one-time purchase block for products that only need a one-time payment and the reoccurring purchase block for products or services that have ongoing payments, like a monthly subscription for a paid newsletter where you offer exclusive content or unique value that can't be found in one of your free newsletters. Now, to learn how to first integrate MailerLite and Stripe, watch our video tutorial linked below. In this video, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about the Stripe product blocks. So let's get started. I'm going to create a new landing page, give it a name, choose the groups for this landing page, and I'll choose a template to make this process a little easier. Okay, we're in the drag and drop editor. To use one of your Stripe blocks, simply drag and drop it from the block menu into the editor. I'm going to choose the reoccurring payment block, but everything I'm demonstrating here also applies to the one-time payment block. When you click the edit icon, you'll be able to modify the look of the block. Now remember, the image and description that are displayed right here are integrated from your Stripe product page. To make any changes, you'll need to log into your Stripe account and make these changes in the Stripe product page. You can edit the success page here, click on the edit icon and modify the text in the body of the message, and change the button right here. Change the orientation of the block here, and edit the text of the checkout button right here. Lastly, you need to choose the products from your store. I'm going to choose a newsletter. The action after successful checkout field is below. Here you can select what happens after your subscribers purchased your product successfully. You can either add them to a group or remove them from a group, or you can edit a custom field to separate these subscribers from the rest of your subscribers. If you choose none, nothing will happen after a checkout and your subscribers will simply make their purchase and go on with their day. You can also choose action after cancel, which is what happens when a customer cancels their subscription. To edit the style settings, click on the settings tab, and here you can edit the padding, the alignment, the font of the different elements, as well as the checkout button. I recommend you to check this box so every reoccurring purchase block that you create for this landing page or website will have the same exact settings that I just created here. Don't forget to click apply. Now I want to quickly show you what a one-time purchase block looks like. It's basically exactly the same, except you can also add a downloadable URL of the digital product that your customer just purchased. To do that, start in the Content tab, switch the Active Editor to the Success Message, and add the digital product URL right here. Now, if you don't add the URL in this section, the successful purchase email will not be sent, so don't forget to do it. Okay, now back to the reoccurring purchase block. And now let's save and publish, and here we are on the overview page. When a customer purchases any digital product from your website, they will receive an automatic email notification from MailerLite, which includes the details of their purchase. To edit these emails, you need to be on the overview page where we at right now, but there's another way to get here. Click on Sites. Click on the overview button of the landing page or website containing your Stripe blocks, and then go to the Stripe tab. In the analytics, you can find a list of customers who have purchased your product in Stripe. You can see their email addresses, a record of their activity, the date of their last recorded activity, and their IP addresses. For one-time products, choose the Digital Products tab, and here you can edit the automatic email that is sent to your customers after they buy a product by clicking the Edit buttons. The subject and sender are pretty straightforward, and for the email content, you will be sent back to the drag and drop editor. Once you're happy with the edit, click Done Editing, and you'll be back in the Stripe tab. For reoccurring subscriptions, you'll see these two options, the subscription created and the subscription canceled. These emails let customers know that their subscription has successfully started or canceled. To edit both, follow the same steps I showed you earlier. And that's it. You can now sell digital products and monetize your newsletters using MailerLite and Stripe.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to click the bell button below so you don't miss any new tutorials. You can also find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and subscribe to our newsletter. The link is in the description section below. Have an awesome day or night, and I'll see you in the next video.